Greetings, everyone, from Atlanta. The Hawks playing host to an Eastern Conference game here on their home floor. I'm Kevin Harlan alongside Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge is joining us from the sideline. This road trip for the Celtics kicking things off here in this one. Well, they're entering a bit of a soft spot in their schedule, facing off guys against some of the lower-ranked teams in the league, and we'll see if they're able to take advantage and pad their win total.
And I think for Boston, not a perfect start to the season, but they're in a position where all it takes is one modest winning streak to jump into that top spot.
I'm guessing they're not that far off. They may be taking a while to hit their stride here, but once they get going, they'll be off to the races.
And in the early part of the season, Steve, teams are usually at their healthiest. How do you maintain that healthy factor throughout the long season?
You know, I love what these organizations are doing, and also players individually. They're getting their rest. They're looking, they're having the individual trainers on the side. Nutritionists play a huge role right now. And I think for a lot of the younger guys, you can't be afraid to ask the veteran what he's doing. And I think that's what a lot of the veterans right now are taking these young guys under their wing and not only teaching them the skill level on the court, but how to maintain their bodies throughout the season.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. On the floor for Boston. Irving at point with Brown to his side. They're the backcourt. Horford is out there with Jason Tatum. And it's Baines in at center. Here's Young following the basket by Jaylen Brown. Fires for three. Another three for Atlanta.
And if he can hit that shot, it spreads the defense out and really changes the complexion of the game.
Opens up opportunities for everyone. Makes the offense its most dynamic.
Irving from long range hits the three-point bomb. Irving's got himself on the board with three there.
Okay, it's on. Trading blows here from distance.
You know what? Both sides are in rhythm. The defense out there having no effect.
To the wing right side. Hawks passing it around. Just five to shoot. From the arc. Connects from three-point range. He's got six.
You just can't leave anyone open around Young. He's very capable of spotting his uncovered teammates.
Irving kicks to Baines. To the paint. Here's Brown. The shot's good on the assist by Horford. Brown's got his second bucket of the game to go.
He turned on the Jets. As soon as he got that screen, it went right to the hole. Great decision making there.
Here's Young. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
They already got into a nice flow. 4 for 5 from the field.
The pass to Irving. That three off the mark. Actioned on 4 of 5 from the field so far.
Well, fans were worried that Kent Bazemore was going to plateau after his big contract. Put those fears to rest last season. Pretty good numbers all around for the Old Dominion grad.
Here's Brown. Score it. His third straight basket in three tries.
And that's where Brown is at his best. A muscular beast who loves finishing strong through the contact.
Young passes to Bazemore. Good for the best. Starting off 1 for 1 with that shot. Celtics trail by 4. So the Celtics call timeout, their first. A tough loss coming against New York in their last game played. And the Hawks with a completely new group on the floor. And a new group in for the Celtics. Marcus Morris has checked in for Aaron Baines. Hayward comes in for Tatum. Smart's checked in for Brown. And Terry Rozier subbed in for Kyrie Irving.
Working over that in-between area, Gordon Hayward with the size and skills to get it done.
Pass to Bembry. Deadman in the corner. Lock at six. And here's Hayward. He gives the team some steady offense, a bit under 10 points a game. Smart goes in. .114 left in the first quarter. Six on the shot clock. Takes it from 10. Here's Horford. He nails it, and we're tied up.
I'll tell you, there's no quitting him when it comes to the offensive glass.
50 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. Collins up top. Herter guarded by Smart. Herter. And Rozier pulls it down. For Boston, they've gone 6 of 8 in the game so far. A very solid start for them. He kicks it to Smart. Now here is Horford. He's coming off a 10-point game against New York. Three-pointer, Hayward. It's good from long range. Hayward's got 5.
Hey, numbers don't lie. Catch and shoot equals high percentage. Gordon Hayward with a great look.
Well, it's been a high-scoring competitive game through the first quarter of play. Boston on top. They lead by 3. And don't go away. We'll be back momentarily. The Celtics have shown their toughness and their determination. Kyrie Irving talks about what he sees in his own teammates.
What's going to separate us is how close we are. And when we're in the trenches together, I'm looking to my left and to my right and knowing that these guys have my back.
They certainly do.
And the Celtics have assembled some hard-nosed, unselfish players. Really no better group for Irving to surround himself with.
Some good action already in this one, but a fairly even matchup after the first quarter of play. And what do you guys think about Boston here in this one?
Well, what's that saying, guys? Sharing is caring. Just terrific ball movement here in that first quarter.
What they did, they left their egos in the locker room. It's a very all-for-one, one-for-all mentality.
On the court for the Celtics, second quarter underway. Hayward and Morris, your small and power forwards. Rozier is out there with Smart. And it's Horford in at the 5 spot. Now here is Carter, and right now he's averaging about 7 points a game. Here's Lynn, rebounded by the Celtics. And this matchup with the Hawks, it's their first meeting of the season.
And as you would expect, they came out on top in last season's series against this club, but no reason to expect anything different this time around.
They just seem to match up very well whenever they play these guys. You can tell they have a ton of confidence.
And he makes that one.
And Lynn is just fearless, always looking to get as close to the bucket as he can.
Well, the Hawks didn't have the best season a year ago, Smitty, but they did find some positives to build on.
Well, the Hawks, what they do have, they have good wing play. A lot of disruptive players who can force turnovers on the defensive end. There's been some great wings in Hawks history, and they have a few on this team right now.
And this is one of those times where the coach has got to preach, be unselfish.
And we don't know that he hasn't. Maybe it's been falling on deaf ears. Guys taking ill-advised jump shots.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks. I know, Steve, when you were an amateur basketball player, some people had suggested they're not teaching enough skill. Now that same refrain is heard. But then you see young players like Jason Tatum, Dennis Smith Jr. What's your opinion now?
You know, I think people look at these players individually, and I think these young guys coming up in youth basketball, the individual player that plays better gets the 4-star, the 5-star. So a lot of these guys want to be that player. We don't put enough emphasis on team basketball. So whereas you're just as important as the best guy. And I think if we can change that narrative, you will see that. But skill-wise, I think we're okay for our skills with guys with the basketball. I think now we got to have guys understanding how to play without it in their hands.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Young finds Bazemore. Prince against Tatum. Prince, right side. Pass to Poythress. Back to Prince. Three-pointer. Great D that time from Tatum. Celtics leading by six. Hayward dishes to Irving. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter.
Can't connect from 13 feet out.
Prince kicks to Young. Good on the three-point shot.
The first thing that jumps out at you about Young, that seemingly limitless shooting range and the spacing that affords for this offense.
Now, here is Irving. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against New York.
And even while he was piling up all those points, he still found a way to create chances for his teammates. The assists just kept on coming.
Now, here's Bazemore after Gordon Hayward's miss. And Bazemore kicks to Young. Over Irving. Len controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
And, folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
Irving surveying the floor. Over Young. And he gets that one to go off the front iron. Irving's got 5 points so far.
For a guy who is 6'3", Kyrie shows us he has great confidence playing inside.
Brown against Bazemore. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Hawks will retain possession. And some changes here for the Celtics. Al Horford's checked in for Aaron Baines. Marcus Morris comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Smart subbed in for Jaylen Brown. There's 21 seconds left in the first half. Shot clock at 6. Here's Bembry. Hits the front of the rim and out.
He likes to work that in-between area, upset with himself that he couldn't connect.
Back to Irving. Fires from deep. No good on the last second attempt there.
And right there, Young may never have the physical tools to be a great defender, but his competitiveness overrides it.
And some good action through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Celtics lead by 3. And we'll be back right after halftime to get the third quarter underway.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello! You're watching the NBA Halftime Show on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson here at this beautiful table. This is a beautiful, beautiful table.
What is this, oak?
That is. I think it's teak.
Oh, teak.
There's Shaq. There's Kenny.
It's polished oak.
Teak. It's polished very nice. Teak. It's very nice.
You mean antique?
No, it's just teak.
Teak.
I have an auntie.
Gordon Hayward has been all over the floor tonight. He had 12 points and 2 rebounds. He's clearly shaken off his mediocre performance from their last game as he has been dominant in the first half tonight. Kenny, what's your take on Boston so far?
Well, their playmakers are showing up tonight, seeing the court well, moving the basketball. That's why they had so many assists in the first half. And they're not just relying on ISO plays to generate points.
And Shaq, what'd you see from Atlanta?
Well, Ernie, I'm not even a player anymore, but I'm not happy with the soft defense they had. Full of holes, allowing over 60% shooting. Ridiculous, fellas. It's amazing that they're still in this game. I think it's going to come down to how bad they want it. I even want it. Ernie, sign me on a 10-day contract right now.
And that's going to do it for us here. The second half of action is coming your way.
And we welcome you back with a look at such a terrific location here in the heart of downtown Atlanta. And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Really an incredible game from Gordon Hayward.
Yeah, so far they haven't found an answer for him, a scoring machine here in that first half.
Defensively coming in, you know he's going to be tough to stop, but I'm still waiting to see a plan to even contain him.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Over on the wings, it's Bazemore and Prince. Then it's Young. Then there's Len. So that's the lineup for Atlanta. Tatum passes to Irving. Back to Tatum. And Baines kicks to Tatum. Brown against Bazemore. And it's Brown missing. The Hawks trail by three. Now Bazemore. His scoring has been there on a regular basis. He's averaging more than 14 points a game. And off the left side of the rim, and it swirls in for him. And that's 12 points for Trae Young. Irving against Young. Elbow shot. 2 points. That one goes. That's 7 points for Kyrie Irving.
What's nice about this in-between area for Kyrie, compared to going to the rim, he has a little more room to get his shot off.
Now, here is Young. He's got 12. Can't connect from 14 feet out. Young against Irving. Right around a minute and a half played here in the third quarter. Back to Horford. Tatum kicks to Horford. Here's Irving. No good that time. And Atlanta will come the other way.
Just 1 for 4 since the break. They are looking for better efficiency on the offensive end.
It's Young on the wing. Shot clock at 5. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. We'll have a jump ball. And so it's Atlanta with it. And here's Prince outside. And Horford pulls it down. Horford's got 5 rebounds tonight. Aldorian Prince out of Baylor. He had a fantastic breakout year for the Hawks.
Well, you knew there would be an opportunity last year in Atlanta. Prince made the most of it. Stepped in as a leader on offense and defense. Still very young and has all the confidence he needs to build on his success.
And that one falls for Tatum. And Smitty, if you had to boil it down to a single play in your career, what was your biggest moment?
Kevin, I'm glad you asked that question. I can also get it out there to everybody in the basketball universe. Game 7, Western Conference Final. Shaq fouled me, and then I called the foul. Shaq fouled me, Kevin. That play still haunts me. I'm still mad.
Really? After all these years?
Yes. And he still lets me know that he didn't foul me, but we got to run the tape. He fouled me.
Now, here's Collins. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Now, here's Rozier. He's tightly guarded. Lynn against Irving. Carter dishes to Lynn. Deadman kicks to Collins. Lock at 6. Carter breaks a big high bounce and goes in. Celtics leading by 3. Irving finds Horford. Outside Tatum. Hayward on the wing. And there's the rebound by Deadman.
Woo, that's the one when you watch the film back. He's going to cringe. He couldn't ask for a better opportunity.
Shot by Collins, no good. The Celtics have gone only 1-5 from the field since halftime. Very slow start offensively. And so Lynn will bring it up for Atlanta. Just 4 points. That's all they've given up here in the second half. Right wing. Carter, left side. And it's Jason Tatum with the foul. That's his first foul.
And really, these are some of the toughest calls an official has to make.
Bembry's checked in for the Hawks. And then for Boston. Morris is checked in for Tatum. And Marcus Smart is subbed in for Irving. Collins passes to Dedmon. Outside, Lynn, 4 on the shot clock. And stolen by Hayward. And he tries off the glass, but it's no good. The Hawks trail by 3. Carter kicks to Dedmon. Lynn the pass to Collins. And that one is off. Good work defensively by Morris. Here's Hayward. That's good, and it's Rozier with the assist. Hayward's got 14 points for the game.
Well, we know he's been confident with the shot. A big reason why they're ahead in this game.
Bembry the pass to Lynn. We've got 22 seconds left in the third. Collins kicks to Lynn. Wide open shot is on the money. Lynn's got his second basket of the night. Boston leading by 3. Rozier looking around. Hayward right side over Collins. Great D on that shot, and it's off the mark. 3 quarters of play in a close game here. Boston on top. They're up by 3. 2K Sports back in a moment here in Atlanta. And now let's go back to a play from earlier as we show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, a terrific, unselfish play right here. Set up his teammate, and how about the setup this was?
At his position, traditionally, his job is to shoot the basketball. Give him credit for keeping his eyes up and just taking what the defense allows.
And with these teams locked in a very close contest, this fourth quarter promises to be a good one. And a look at the 5 for the Celtics to start the fourth quarter. Down low, it's Morris and Horford. Smart and Brown outside on the wings. And it's Rozier in at the 1 spot. Now Rozier after the miss 3 from Trae Young. Nice shot by Smart.
And you don't want to allow too many of those short ones with the game right now in the balance.
Bembry the pass to Young. The 19-foot shot. That one wide left. Boston leading by 5. Rozier with the ball. Here's Morris. It's stolen. A little over a minute of the fourth quarter gone right now. And it's in there.
On the attack, he has that ability, trying to close this one out.
Yeah, and the rim protection, not there. You expect someone to at least come over and contest.
Timeout. You know, that's an example of how many plays we have in the game for which there's no stat. A monster dunk coming off just a terrific pick play.
Greg, you're right. It really did work to perfection. Gave him all the room he needed for the flush.
That's what happens when you get an excellent screen like that. He had plenty of space to slash right toward the basket.
And no doubt that Marcus Smart is one of the better defenders at his position. Quick feet are complemented by that strong frame, and he just digs in and against would-be scorers and just never lets them get comfortable.
So for the Hawks, Alex Lenz check in for Poitras. Torian Prince comes in for Vince Carter. And it's Kent Bazemore in for Benford. Aaron Baines, he's checked in for the Celtics. And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
I was able to listen in on Lloyd Pierce talking with his team. They have been getting killed from long range tonight, and he said, we can't lose track of their shooters. We're overpacking the lane, and we're leaving them wide open. Guys, we'll see if they can make the adjustment.
And the call will be against Alex Len. That is his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Celtics. Jason Tatum comes in for Marcus Smart, and Irving subbed in for Terry Rozier. Tatum against Prince. Tatum kicks to Brown. Shot clock at 6. And Trae Young gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. And Greg was smart. When he's off the floor or injured, you notice just how it changes the team's defense.
Yeah, I mean, the defense overall just seems to have less bite, less edge, less toughness without Smart. And the way he plays, you feel like he is looking to make a play on defense rather than just trying to slow his man down. Great at taking charges and forcing turnovers. He is truly the catalyst of their defense.
Now, here is Young.
And this is Young at his very best. Once he gets a few to fall, boy, watch out.
Tatum passes to Irving. For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. And so Bazemore will bring it up for the Atlanta Hawks, trailing by 5. Shots good from Young.
This is why people are just so high on Young, because he comes through with big shots in the game.
Now, here is Irving over Young. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. And 11 points for Kyrie Irving.
When the lights are at his brightest, Kyrie loves coming through.
Irving against Young. Spellman. The shot that time, not on target. Good work defensively by Morris. Brown wide open, he fires. And the three ball is good. Brown's got the lead up to 7 now for the Celtics. Atlanta's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. 1:30 left in the fourth quarter of this one. For Boston, they've gone 5 of 6 from the field to start the fourth quarter on a roll. Irving kicks to Tatum. Back to Irving. Gets that one to fall. That's his 6th field goal. He has shot the ball 12 times.
Kyrie sprung free on that pick and roll. Trying to stick with him is easier said than done.
Atlanta calls timeout. They're trailing by 9. 1:14 left to play here in the fourth. And now the presentation of our Jordan player of the game, Gordon Hayward.
And he's been dialed in from the field, Kevin. Good on over 60% of his attempts. They've been working the ball around well, and he's benefited with a lot of open looks. And boy, has he made the most of them.
And at last, he gets a little redemption. You know, it's been several games since he's been at his best. He's really been having a tough time. Now, here is Young. Len dishes to Young. To halt the run, 8 for 15 with that made basket, but he's not satisfied yet.
You know, fending off the defense well there, Young solid at just being crafty enough in these types of situations.
Prince against Tatum. Outside Irving. Back to Tatum. Irving against Young. Here's Baines. Tatum passes to Horford. Back to Tatum. Over Collins. Tatum's shot is off. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. The 11-footer. It's in! Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
Terrific score when they needed it the most. Bazemore in this situation, he remained calm.
Nineteen seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one, and he commits the intentional foul.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
He hits the first one, and that increases their lead to six.
You know, when you talk to Kyrie, smart guy, cerebral guy, thinks about the game at the highest level.
And so he drops them both. It's a seven-point game.
And he just garnered a little bit more insurance there. Very confident as he's able to go up and knock those down.
Time called here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. They're behind by seven. There's 18 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what do you think?
Yeah, it's a dejected group of guys. I mean, they've got a lot of pride and just hadn't happened for them here tonight.
The most important thing to remember, it's not over, but they have to step up on both ends to have a chance.
Yeah, not a great shot there, especially when you got a lockdown defender guarding you.
You know, there's no shame in passing out in that situation. Leave your ego at the door.
And so it's the Boston Celtics with the W. This was a hard-fought, well-earned victory for them, Greg. They really had to work for this win.
That's a good point. I mean, weaker teams might have buckled at the end with the crowd amped up, everyone in the building kind of rooting against you, but they stood tall and pulled it out.
Well said. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, guys. Gordon, nice win for you guys tonight. What was the difference?
Energy. I think we play with a lot of energy, passion, especially defensively. You know, when we're all doing our job and we're playing and we're focused and we're solid defensively, we're not really having lapses, we can be a pretty good team. You know, that we don't have to walk the ball up the court and it's not as difficult on our offense. So it all starts defensively, and I think it all starts with energy down there.
You've become one of the best young defensive teams in the league, Gordon. Thanks very much. Back to you.
All right, David, thank you. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. Now for Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge. This is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA here on 2K Sports. See you next time.